Thank you. We'll now move back to public comment. Again, a public comment session. You're limited to 5 minutes. Please come forward to the microphone. And as you know, the microphone is not working, so speak up. Say it's going to be for the city clerk. Be respectful, get the cell phone, please turn it off. If you're ready for that, please remove it. Thank you. You have 5 minutes. First speaker, please.
Much better to be known for
landslide buses, were homeward near Binghamton, and I was not intending to come and speak to them, that wasn't my purpose. But I believe that the committee, actually the council, should hear all sides on this issue. And I have no doubt that everyone here has a wonderful heart, just as all of Americans, as the city does, and that they believe this is one of the great things we should do. I disagree. I believe that's incorrect. This is no different than the same issue that's being discussed and was already discussed in Utica. And in Utica, the Democrats, several Democrats, that put forth opposition to this very same idea, a resolution to welcome refugees. Utica, by the way, receives about 10 times as many refugees as we do. And that issue, at the end of the day, was put on hold because of the term. The city council doesn't have an authority, which is why this is a non-binding resolution. Now, I don't have to prepare it, but please follow up on this. First, the resolution, by its definition, by its take as a welcoming resolution, implies that we, as people of Binghamton, New York State, and Maryland, do not welcome refugees. That's it. We take in approximately 70,000 refugees every year. Our city takes in dozens of refugees and already have, and we will continue to do so, no matter what the society takes. So I wish to throw out that first law as implied by definition of this resolution, which I know many people find insult because it applies a law. Second, I want to address another about this resolution. We've had many people speak about the refugees that are coming. They're coming in no matter. President Obama has already made that decision. It's already going to happen. We know that Governor Cuomo has already made the decision, and he's going to have them come in into our state and be dispersed. We don't know where they're going. Well, few, we know where they're going. 7,000 people are going. We will probably receive some as well. That's fine. We are a welcoming community. We are a welcoming people. We always have. We will welcome them when we show up. So let us also keep in mind that this is a discussion that is for the American people. We have not had a chance on the national level, under President Obama, to be able to speak our voice. We have not had a chance under Governor Cuomo to speak our voice. These were decisions that were made for us and not with us. And today, I have to say, I am upset because this discussion is going on so rapidly that the majority of people in this city do not know about it. I was on the radio 3 days ago, Friday, speaking about this issue on air. The host of that radio program was not aware of this. I have spoken to people across this entire city, both in email and in person, and no one is aware of this. We are rushing this. If this is an issue that we have to take up, this is an issue to be taken up in 2016, as we have more information, as the public gets to be aware of it, so that we can then make a decision as a city. Lastly, I would say, one of the most important things that we have to look at is that whether we have refugees in this city or not, whether or not the concerns of those refugees are in terms of the safety for us is addressed at the national level, which is in dispute. We have to remember that our main focus must be that we have a city that stands right now with 6.7% unemployment, which is higher than the entire state. We have 33% poverty in this city. We have 47% of the children in the city living in poverty. We need job growth. We need to be able to take care of our own. We need to be able to help those who come here from New York City, from Zimbabwe, Rwanda, or wherever else they may be. We have the 41 documents, which are petitions. I know the online petition includes individuals from Rwanda, from Florida, from Texas, from California. These are not the voices of the people in the city. I can't say this. They do not reflect Moretti.
Thank you. I rise and ask unanimous consideration for introductory resolution 15-126.
Second.
This is a resolution in support of refugees, and I'm going to read it. Whereas the Refugee Act of 1980 declared that it is the historic policy of the United States to respond to the urgent needs of persons subject to persecution in their homeland, and they have the power to handle any unforeseen emergency refugee situation, such as the one involving grave humanitarian concerns. And whereas the people of Binghamton have a long history of opening their community and welcoming refugees. And whereas Binghamton, New York is proud to be an ethnically diverse city with 9.4% of its residents born outside the United States, indicating that Binghamton is truly a city of immigrants. And whereas Binghamton is proud of its immigrant communities, including Vietnamese, Laotian, Kurdish, Bosnian, Somali, Sudanese, Burmese, Cuban, and other communities made up of all religions, and many of whom arrived here under the status of refugee. And whereas on average 45 to 60 refugees are resettled into the Binghamton area each year since 2009. And whereas the American Civic Association has resettled thousands of refugees since their establishment in 1939. Whereas the number of refugees fleeing conflict in Syria to neighboring countries has now eclipsed 4 million, thus confirming the Syrian refugee crisis as the world's single largest refugee crisis in almost a quarter of a century, which Binghamton should not ignore and should stand ready to respond to this humanitarian crisis. And whereas refugees to the United States are subject to the highest level of security checks of any category of travel to our country. And whereas refugees are vetted by the National Counterterrorism Center, the FBI's Terrorist Screening Center, and the Departments of State, Defense, and Homeland Security. And whereas refugees are subject to additional screening that verifies or causes them to flee their homes. Whereas the intensive background and medical checks required of refugees can take as much as 2 years to complete. Whereas more than half of the refugees brought to the United States have fed children. Whereas a public statement that Binghamton is a welcoming community implicitly and clearly conveys that Binghamton will self-identify as a compassionate city. And whereas Binghamton, as part of the world community, can and should play a role, however small, in the collective response to fear mongering and human suffering. Be it resolved that we, the members of the Binghamton City Council, a body of elected officials that represent the people from a multitude of ethnicities and religions, reaffirm our commitment to remain a place of support for the refugees who have in past years made Binghamton their home. Be it further resolved that Binghamton City Council, a body of elected officials that represent people from a multitude of ethnicities and religions, affirm and express a commitment to be a welcoming community to any and all future refugees who have gained sanctioned entrance to the United States of America.
Councilwoman Webb.
Aye.
Councilman Capistrat.
Nay.
Councilman Motzel.
Nay.
Councilman Burke.
Nay.